Be ready. On the count of 3, 2, 1, start. Sir, I rise to support the railway budget for 1992-93. The railways are one of the biggest media for communication and to carry people and the goods and serve the nation. Here we have found that the railways are really aware of their duties and responsibilities, and it is one source by which our economy can gain momentum and which helps to fulfill our social obligation. We respect the Indian Railways. However, there is still room for improvement of services to be rendered to individual passengers. A lot has to be done towards improvement of railway stations, cleanliness and catering service. We have to initiate a number of steps to plug leakage of revenue during transportation, that is during movement of goods from one place to the other. This will surely help the economy and also minimize damages and also minimize the claims from affected persons. The railway ministry have to think in terms of rehabilitation and renovation of railway track and also conversion of meter gauge into broad gauge lines in tribal areas. My humble suggestion for broad gauge line to be considered in the 8-5-year plan is from Balsar in Gujarat to Nasik in Maharashtra. This will help in the development of the tribal belt in both the states and will provide many opportunities to the people of the area. This is a very long pending demand with the central government. I hope the Honorable Minister would think in this direction and satisfy both the states. The performance of the railways is satisfactory when we see the data provided by the minister. The growth of passenger traffic is 5%. There is control on the working expenses. By putting in extra efforts, the earnings are increasing at a satisfactory level. Keeping in view the demands and requirements, 15 new trains are being introduced from 1st July 1992. We are thankful to the Honorable Minister for this. However, these are much less in number considering the growing demand. The service improvement group is to be activist so that the local problems of each and every area could be attended to and resolved to the greater satisfaction of the passengers. In this connection, I demand that computerized reservation system should be introduced at Surat in Gujarat. As you know, Surat is an industrial center. This is a long-standing demand. It is high time computerized reservation system was introduced at Surat. This will be helpful to thousands of passengers of Gujarat and Maharashtra, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala and Orissa too. In the budget, there is an enormous hike in the suburban fares. Upper class fares have been increased by 20%. The increase in the second class fares is between 11 and 17%. It has been stated that the input cost of the railways has gone up by 8 times, but the increase in the passenger fares has been less than 4 times in the last 2 decades. freight rates have been increased by 7%. In the case of coal, it is 4%. There is also a sizable increase in the case of parcel rates from 25% to 50%. As a result of these increases, prices will go up and consequently inflation. Directly or indirectly, the middle class and the lower class of the society will suffer. Their purchasing power will go down. Travel will become costly for the urban people and the common man. The items for which the raw material is coal will automatically become costly. As the cost of production will increase by 4%, the increase in the revenues will be helpful to the railways and the elite sections of the society in one way or another. The thrust given to gauge conversion, electrification and technical upgradation will further improve the performance of the railways in the days to come. Here I would like to point out that a state like Gujarat has not at all been included for gauge conversion. In the context of the critical economic situation, the Honorable Minister has done his best to make the railways more effective, productive and profitable in the days ahead. The performance of the railways in the year 1991-92 is commendable, particularly when we see that the general industrial growth has declined. I now come to some specific demands, some specific problems concerning my state, namely Gujarat. Gujarat is getting coal irregularly due to shortage of rigs. In the morning, during question hour, we discussed about model railway stations. Navsari and Porbandar are two international and historical places. Lakhs of tourists are coming each year, but there are no facilities, no amenities at both the station. Navsari city is a prosperous city, industrial and historical city. I must say that some amenities should be provided. We wrote some letters for providing amenities at these railway stations. I request the minister, sir, to do something in this respect.